Hey, what is up? What is up, you guys? Little vulnerability here. I am in my hot tub here in beautiful Colorado. It's like 25 degrees, and I started my day off with major purpose. Got up at 4 a.m., prayed, meditated, thought about you, thought about everything that I'm doing for the day, and I've had you on my mind, and I wanted to talk to you. I just got done listening to an amazing podcast of my mentor, Sean Dale and Lacey Book. And man, I sure love you guys. So huge shout out to you guys in the Black Diamond Club and all that you guys have done for me and my business and the relationships that I have cultivated. But I want to talk to you guys about the New Year goals. This time of year, social media is all over this. Everyone's all over this about New Year's resolutions. And if you are just now thinking for the first time, hey, I need to do something different. Hey, good for you if you're recognizing that. But what I would encourage you to do is now is not the time, the first time, for you to be thinking of the next year. And when we talk about goals, we shouldn't be thinking about goals at the end of the year. We should be thinking in a 365-day review of all the good that goes on, that all the good that has happened. So I want to go over four criteria that you need to be going over for your business, for your personal life, your family life, and everything that we should be going over. So number one, when you go over your goals, we need to be able to, at any time of the year, know what is going ahead, what is happening. So what has worked well? What went super, super well? And don't just think business, think personally. Hey, in my personal life, what went well? In my personal life, how's my family relationship? How's the relationship with my spouse, with my kids? How's my relationship spiritually with members of my church, my faith, God? Think professionally, think of your businesses, what went well. And what we tend to think of is when it went well, for some reason, we don't magnify and blow up what went well. We decide to do something different. Hey, this one event did so well, let's do something different. Let's do something kinda like that. What you need to be focusing on is whatever went well, magnify that, put love and intention and money into that, put more human resource behind that and explode it. Focus on what went well, what is growing, and amplify that. You also need to focus on what didn't go well, or AKA lessons learned. What didn't go well and why didn't go well? Was it the application of it? Was it implementation? Was it lack of follow-up? Was it lack of a system in place? And figure out if it is gonna go work well, what has to happen? And if not, number three, we gotta stop it. What are you doing that are time suckers, time wasters? What are the people in your life who are just draining you, that you are putting so much give into that aren't helping you? They are just takers. Who are the people that you need to thank and let go? Who are the people that you need to be grateful for? Who are the people that you should be creating relationships with? This is one of the biggest blessings I've had the last several years of my business, is creating relationships. And as we talk about, return on relationships will eat return on investments any day of the week. ROR eats ROI any day of the week. And developing these relationships is what is so critical. So what is not working well? You got to stop it. And at the end, what do you need to start? What have you promised to do, committed to do? What do you have a system for? What do you have a playbook for that needs to happen? So again, if you're just realizing, wow, I haven't done I haven't implemented this system, and the system is going to work. It's been tried, tested, true by those who have already done it. That's what you absolutely have to do. Hey, Glenn, good morning, my man. Good to see you, brother. So you have to create relationships, and you have to be able to create the systems with the right people to help you grow. So again, this should be something that you are talking about and planning. Our whole year is planned out, and as opportunity comes, we recognize opportunity because we know who I'm going to be working with. One thing that we have implemented that has been a game changer in my life is doing my five non-negotiables. What are my five non-negotiable, or I apologize, what are my five daily practices? And then I have three non-negotiables. Five daily practices is every morning when I get up at 4 a.m., I say thank you, I pray, and then I meditate. And I meditate on five things. What do I want? Who can I help with what I want, or who can help me? How am I gonna get what I want? When am I gonna do it, and why? I ask that for everything personally going on in my life, professionally in my life, spiritually in my life. I focus on my family. If my family, how many of you say your family is your top priority, yet you don't spend a single time with your family? So my three non-negotiables are my health. I will get up in the morning, I will pray, I will meditate, I will work out, I will eat healthy. I will prepare my mind because I can't be my best for you. I can't be my best for my family. I can't be my best for my team if I'm not my best for myself. I can't give what I don't have. You guys, you cannot give what you don't have. You cannot help someone become rich if you are poor. You cannot be rich-minded if you are poor-minded. You can't give what you don't have. We are an accumulative sum of the top five people that we hang out with. So you have to look at the people you associate with. What is their character? What does their wealth look like? Who are they? What are they wanting to accomplish? Who do they run in circles with? Who are their circles of influence? That's what you have to look at. Don't you love the steam coming off me? And by the way, if you guys don't have a morning routine where you can center yourself and just be able to express gratitude, I got up this morning and it was completely dark outside and it was just absolutely just beautiful. Hey, Levi, good to see you, brother. So number one, you have to practice your five daily habits, your five daily disciplines every day, your three non-negotiables. So number one, again, as I spoke about, is my daily health. You have to put focus into your daily health. Number two is my family, is what are you doing for your family? So again, how many of you say, I'm going to spend time with my family today? You don't spend time with your family. Or during your family time, you're on your phone. During your family time, you're on a phone call. So you have to do that. So in a few minutes, I'm going to go wake up my family. In a few minutes, we're going to eat breakfast together. We're going to do scripture study together. We're going to plan our day together. After that, my wife and I have a private meeting with ourselves where we work on our relationship. Then after that, we work on our business. And we plan and we grow together. That's a non-negotiable for me. And then number three is then I do the things that I get paid for, activities I get paid for, which is my business. Then I focus and plan on that. So you have to be planning these things out every single day. You have to have a daily plan, a weekly plan, a monthly plan, a yearly plan. So that, and you start recognizing opportunities. When opportunity comes, you strike. In the last 3 or 4 months, we have met with some incredible mentors. Dr. Glenn Vo, who is the founder of Nifty Thrifty Dentist and multiple other lucrative, life-changing businesses. We partnered with him. We partnered with Sean Dillon Lacey Book. We partnered with Dave Meltzer. We partnered with several other team members in BDC. I have several other businesses we've started. We've started 4 other businesses this year. And I am unbelievably excited because opportunity came. 3 of those businesses, we had 0 idea we were gonna start it, but we recognized opportunity. So look at your year, plan your year. What worked well? What went really well? What needs to be improved? What needs to be stopped? And what needs to be started? Plan that out. Who can help you get your what? What do you want? Who can help you? How are you going to achieve it? When are you going to achieve it? And why? If you are not a student of your calendar, if you are not looking at your calendar every single day, if you're not looking at your calendar multiple times throughout the day to be sure you are on task with what you want, Dave Meltzer teaches that when you are overwhelmed, that is a sign of abundance. It means you have an abundance, but your priorities have been lost. If you catch yourself wasting time on Facebook and you didn't plan for that, that's not what you wanted to do. If you caught yourself on a phone call that didn't matter, if you caught yourself doing something that doesn't matter, it's because you lost priority. You lost track of what mattered most. You have to focus on what matters most. So when you do those 5 daily practices, when you're a student of your calendar, you absolutely begin to own these things. So, oh, hey, there's my sweetheart, I love. So you guys, as you are students of your calendar, as you plan every single day, as you plan every week, as you plan every month, as you plan your year, you will recognize the people, the opportunities that will give you more options so you can have freedom. 3 of our core founding values in my family are family, faith, and freedom. Being able to do what we love, being able to have options, being able to go on a private island with dear friends and mentors to be able to grow, to change my mindset. I am changed. I wouldn't have had that opportunity just a few years ago if I didn't know who I know now. I am incredibly grateful for who I have in my life. I am grateful. My family, we feel so abundantly blessed. Personally as a family, my practice, Restoration Chiropractic, we feel abundantly blessed. I have the most incredible team. My associate, Dr. Fair, is an incredible human being, and I am so grateful for him. Many of you, if you are not expressing gratitude for those who are around you, some people may understand and feel that. You got to thank people. So I thank you guys for being here. I want to help you grow. I want to take you where you need to be. And again, if you are struggling, if you haven't had a vacation, if you don't have time because you are not prioritizing, if you haven't had the ability to upgrade your lifestyle to the lifestyle you deserve and want, we need to talk. If you're at a level where you are ecstatic, you never thought you could be, let's talk. Because there are always ways to improve and to grow to get you from 1 million to 5, or to get you from 50,000 to 100, 100 to a million. Whatever you want. Some people don't want money. They want quality relationships. They want experiences. Let's talk about what you want in your life. Schedule your day. Focus on the things that matter most. Focus on your year. And let's share and let's grow together in this group. Do me a favor. Add friends to this group. Bring people into this group who will help you grow for accountability. Bring people, bring the chiropractors and other businesses that will help chiropractic grow. Surround yourself with people that you trust. Align yourself with people you trust. We are affiliating with partners that we trust, with Mango Voice, with Kevin Tallman and the people at Mango. You guys, if you're not with Mango, it will save you a ton of money. With Fortis Systems, Fortis Payment Systems, they save us a fortune. It is integrated seamlessly into our business and into our practice. You need to align your business with businesses who support and care for you. So with the right people who support you. So focus, you guys, on the things that bring you joy. Think about what you want. Think about who can help you get what you want, how you can achieve it, when you will achieve it, and why you want that. Enjoy it. So right now, I'm enjoying my awesome hot tub. I'm enjoying my personal health. And now it is family time. And after that, I get to go play. I get to go do an activity I get paid for. So chime in below. Let's become students of our calendars. Let's share our commitments with each other. And let's bring people into this group that will elevate us and bless us.